But yeah, I'm recording right now that one I told you, the big plant. I tied up three of the branches. It's the one that's got the biggest tomatoes on it too, and it's got a bunch of flowers. I mean, Tracy called it, I think 15 flowers on it yet. You got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6
I got
tomatoes.
Flowers on it, but some of the flowers are just dying. They're drying up.
Yeah. Huh, I don't understand why I was doing that. I would water it no more than once every 6 days, 7 days, but just give it a good soaking. You gotta let it soak down. You got holes in the bottom of the buckets, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, because otherwise you'll get root rot. We did that. I'm telling you all the things that I've did that made a mistake. If you don't have holes in the bottom of it, it'll end up backing up the water inside there, and it'll become bacteria. Yeah. Oh, there's another little tomato. Cool. What did I say was on there? 6. There's 7 tomatoes on this one now. 7 tomatoes. Do you see this one? Yeah, 21 flowers on this thing. 21 flowers and 7 tomatoes. And then on this plant right next to it, we got 2 tomatoes. And I'm not going to count the flowers because I can't. I mean, my screen is completely fogged over because of the humidity out here. It's hot. Looks like some Mexican going by. Okay, this is another one here. There's another one that's got 2 tomatoes on it. I see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I see 11 flowers on this one here I'm videoing right now. Got 2 tomatoes on it. Man, again, I don't know if it's gonna come out or fogged up or not. Yeah, we did it with that Epsom salt and sugar yesterday. I did it, and then or the day before yesterday, and then I used some of that Alaskan crap. I didn't like doing that, but I did it anyway. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9? I thought there was more than that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Where you at?
Not to
say. Oh, is that an emergency vehicle or police?
Yeah, it was
an ambulance. Yeah, this one tomato is one I'm so proud of. I wish to goodness this. I hope it all comes out really good. Like I said, I'm videotaping. It was just a bare twig here with a brown leaf on it. Now look at it all back, coming back. So, again, I can't see it too good. I got sunglasses on because of the heat out here in the sun, and the wind, the screen and the view, the screen of view and the lens is all keeps fogging up from the humidity. So, I don't know how much of all this would be clear or not. But yeah, that's the garden out here. Watermelon over there. We got 4 of them growing really good. I mean, not watermelon is but the plant. God damn, flies biting me. It flies out here, big house fly, horse flies and shit too.
You call your back, I got a customer.
Okay, all right, bye. Yeah, man, that's the okra. This is the kind of weather okra loves too. After having that big heavy rain yesterday, you can see that one right in the corner. That's the okra plant right there in the middle. Yeah. They should survive. My beans, I put out too early. Certain types of beans, because look at these. You can see how those look good and healthy right now. These will take the heat good. These evidently, these should have been put out, I guess, in the end of January. I might have to pick all those. Today being as hot as it's going to be, I don't know if I'll pick them today or if I'll wait until, you know, until they're ruined or something tomorrow. So I don't know. But see, all these here, I put these out way too late. Too early. I put them out in the middle of February. The end of February until March. And they should have been put out in the end of January. Let them grow February, March, April, and part of May. But now I thought they would grow in the summer, but they're going to end up growing stunt and overheating. Rest of the beans, these are the ones that you want heat with, evidently. You can see how they're growing. Look how healthy they look compared to these others. See these, the yellow leaves on them. See the bean pods all over that. Yeah, And real quickly before I stop this video, it's going to be long, too long already. See, my zucchinis got rid of the bugs off those. Really good. My cucumbers. My watermelon's here. This one was one of the first ones I planted, and it's about 12 inches spread out only. And then that one there. Man, I can't see. And then look at these two. This. There's one there, and then I planted, that's probably a cantaloupe right there, and then plant watermelon there, and look at this one, how this one's taken off. This one would be the first one probably put out watermelons, but my beans, again, like I say, it's too hot. I mean, they'll live for a while, they'll put out some beans, but nothing. I should have planted them in January. Well, like I said, this is how I'm learning everything each year. Last year was a really, really good one, but it was done a lot different from where it is now. This garden didn't ever put out anything in it at all last year. I tried tomatoes, and I tried peppers, nothing. I tried pumpkin, I mean, nothing on this one was worth anything. It was mainly number three back here, and number one a little bit. This year, though, all of them will put out some things. Most, I'd say probably about 90% of what's in all three gardens will come out. So, beans, majority of these beans, January, plant them, end of January. Peas and certain beans, like, see, and then the other peas and other types of beans you put out, like in the middle to end of April. There's all kind of guides online if you want need to find stuff like that. And your tomatoes you want to put out at the second week, third week of April. But see, out here, with the wind we've had, it was really bad, so that's why we waited so long. And the tomatoes are coming out pretty good, so. With sunflower fence, wind fence, big in the west there. And look how it just goes down. It stays small on the north end, all that small. A little clump right there, and then here on the east end. So. Oh boy, I'll have some food. This, what I get out of this garden will last us for about a year and a half, plus what we had in the freezer from last year. So, grow you some food, folks. That's all I can say. Can't tell you it enough. You need to be able to buy, be able to grow some food. Sustainable food too, not the crap you buy at some of these stores.